I hope you're all having a great end to the week. I am, because earlier this week, macOS Sonoma 14.5 was released, and earlier this morning, I successfully updated my unsupported 2013 MacBook Pro. I'm going to show you every step, but first, some big news regarding unsupported Macs in general. With the latest version of OpenCore Legacy Patcher, older Macs with non-metal graphics cards can now be updated to Sonoma 14.4 and higher. So for those of you with Macs made between 2008 and 2012, you should now be good to go in updating past Sonoma 14.3, and I haven't heard of any issues with 14.4 or 14.5. If you're currently running any version of unsupported Sonoma, the video that you're watching right now will show you the exact steps that you need to update to 14.5 or later, even if you're currently running, say, 14.1. If you haven't updated to unsupported Sonoma yet, check out my original video where in 10 minutes I show you every step of the initial installation. Okay, now for the 14.5 update. The first thing I did was make sure that my laptop was connected to Wi-Fi. Then I searched Spotlight to open up the OpenCore Legacy Patcher application. A pop-up appeared asking me to update to the latest version. This is also where you can read more about OpenCore support for non-metal Macs, so you may want to check that out, and then click Download and Install. Enter your password. When it finishes, it will ask if you want to update OpenCore and the root volume patches. Click Yes, and click on Install to Disk. Choose your main hard drive at first, and then the EFI volume. Enter your password. After OpenCore has finished installing, click Yes to update the root patches, then click Start Root Patching. Click Yes to relaunch the patcher as admin, enter your password again, and let it do its thing. When it finishes, click Reboot, and then Restart to apply the changes. The reboot took about 30 seconds, and the entire process of updating OpenCore took about 4 minutes. Now, for 14.5, I went to my System Settings, then to General, and then to Software Update. After about 30 seconds of checking, a section to the left of the System Settings appeared saying Software Update Available, with a red dot in the number 1. I clicked on it and saw Sonoma 14.5 was available, so I clicked Update Now. Then, things got a little sketchy. I waited about 5.5 minutes with no sign of an update. Finally, it started downloading the update. Everything looked okay until, boom, an error message that I've never seen before. Software updates have changed. Please contact Apple support. I'm not sure they're gonna help me out in this situation. No worries. I used Command Option Escape to force quit out of software update and then closed system settings. Then I went right back in to the general section. Clicked Update Now again, and then after nearly a minute of waiting, the update started to download again, this time without any errors. The actual download took about 14 minutes, but that was after about 10 minutes of troubleshooting to get it started. The download is so large because when doing these incremental updates on unsupported Macs, OpenCore essentially has to reinstall the entire operating system to make sure that everything is set up properly. It's definitely a little bit of a pain in the booty, but not as big of a pain as running an older operating system on my unsupported MacBook Pro. When the download finished, I clicked Restart. Okay, here is where patience comes into play big time. My computer restarted with loading bars 4 times over the course of 16 minutes. My startup disks would appear on each restart, but I didn't click or press anything, and it chose the right disk every time. When the computer finally came up, my wallpaper was black and the UI was very small, clearly needing some post-patch updates here. A pop-up from OpenCore appeared telling me just that, so I clicked OK to install root patches, entered my password, and frantically tried to get my screen recorder running to capture some of it in higher quality, but I failed with that part. Once the root patch finished, a pop-up appeared asking me to restart, so I did. The restart took about a minute, and then I was in. macOS Sonoma 14.5 on my unsupported 2013 MacBook Pro. I tested it out using Google Chrome. Obviously, you can see that my screen recording software worked well, and I also airdropped some files from my MacBook Pro to my iMac. No issues whatsoever. I did notice an odd thing, however, with OpenCore Legacy Patcher. When I opened the application, it asked me to update it again, the same update that I ran before updating to Sonoma 14.5. Looking at the top of OpenCore, it said that I was only running version 1.3. So I did go ahead and I tried to update it again, but it didn't work. It still says version 1.3, even though I've tried installing 1.4.3 twice now. Maybe this is because the update was meant to target non-Metal Macs, which doesn't apply to my 2013 MacBook Pro. Whatever the reason, it's something to keep an eye on, but as my MacBook Pro is now up to date with the latest operating system released from Apple, I'm not going to sweat it too much. If you're looking for more details on upgrading unsupported Macs, including how you can install a Windows 11 partition on older Macs, this playlist right here has all the details. If you found the video that you're watching right now helpful, hit that like button, subscribe for more unsupported Mac adventures. I'm Anson Alexander, and I'll see you in the next one.